Namaste. Greetings to everyone and welcome to this VTU eShikshana program. I, Dr. Dakshayani R. Patil, wish you a wonderful day. And we are beginning with the course Building Services 18 ARC 63 for BArch Bachelor's in Architecture course, 6th semester for the session April to August 2021, currently underway. And we have been doing the modules 1 and 2 on this particular platform. We are towards the end of module 2, section number 4 currently. So, an initiative by Vishveshwaraya Technological University. The lecture sessions under module 1 and 2 underway. So that is overview of syllabus under module 2, of which section 3 we have completed, that is types of air conditioning systems and other ancillary requirements such as ducting, filtration, AHU, etc. So we will begin with the fourth and the last section, specialized air conditioning systems. Today we are going to see clean room systems. So under air conditioning, clean room systems. And this is lecture number 12 under module 2. Clean room systems. So the objectives of today's lecture on clean rooms would essentially cover understanding basics or definition of clean room, the considerations and salient aspects of clean room systems, designing aspects, flow patterns of the supply air that are very crucial in a clean room system, and construction of clean rooms. So how do we undertake the designing and construction of these specialized air conditioning spaces called as clean rooms. Now, what are clean rooms? So basic understanding to kick off with. There are some processes and rooms that require control of contaminants to achieve near zero levels of contamination. So these spaces are the buildings which with these kind of spaces, rooms, or processes, activities happening towards manufacturing or maintenance or production or research. These spaces require zero contamination levels in the indoor air. So there is zero tolerance for any kind of contamination, and it has to be a foolproof clean zone up to 99.999%. So that is the expected level of cleanliness, and hence they are called as clean rooms. For example, ICUs, that is the intensive care unit for the critically ill or requiring such a kind of medical treatment. Pharmaceutical processes in research and production of medicine, vaccinations, and many more. Electronic industry, which are manufacturing these precision tools or gadgets that require zero tolerance. If there were impurities or dirt or dust, then it would hamper the production of the same and give rise to faulty products. Space research, defense labs, to name a few of them. So these all come under the category of clean rooms. And there are a lot of guidelines for the construction, usage, maintenance, and overall addressal of these clean rooms in a building. They vary from a normally designed room in terms of materials, in terms of construction, in terms of activities that can be hosted there. So, a clean room is a specially designed enclosed space where inborn particulates have been limited or removed by a highly sophisticated filtration system. Clean room is a specially designed indoor space where airborne particulates, by that we mean the impurities, dust, dirt, organic molecules dispersed in the air that we breathe. So have been limited, so we have to limit the contamination of the air or totally extract these impurities from the room by a highly sophisticated filtration system. Last session we have seen air filtration system in air conditioning spaces. So we saw the various types available, if you recollect, beginning with pre-filters, CU filters, or what is the other name? Screen filters. So this was the first stage of cleaning. Then we had fine filters, which were 99.9% effective. Then there was HEPA filters, right? High efficiency particulate, HEPA particulate absolute filters. Then there was electronic filters. So there is a combination of various types of filters available. So using the highest efficient filtration system is advisable when we want to design a clean room. So highly sophisticated filtration system is in place. So these are the instances where you can see that it is a totally safe, secure indoor environment. No infiltration of any kind of impurities is recommended or must happen, shouldn't happen there. Now a quick size of the relative sizes of particles before we go ahead. So if you start, we have seen that it is in microns. So 1 micron is 1 by 25,000th an inch. That tiny, invisible to the eye. And you have the human hair, sand, salt, white blood corpuscle, red blood corpuscle, dust particles, etc. Red blood cell, respiratory droplets, dust particles, bacteria, the coronavirus, which comes at the bottom three, Zika virus, right? There are so many of these scaled impurities that are dispersed in the air. And the filtration system that we select must aim to filter out the most probable contaminant in the space. If it were a COVID ward, for instance, we would definitely want to check out a filter which is going to screen out the bottom three. For screening out such a minuscule impurity, we need the best type of high efficiency filtering media. So that is the intent. But if we were by a beach house or by a beach on a clubhouse or an entertainment zone, that we would restrict to the top three or four. So screen filters would do the job. That is the kind of decisions we have to take on what is the degree of filtration that needs to be done based on the probable contamination of the air in a given building. Now we will look at the various considerations with respect to clean room aspects. The five important air conditioning design considerations for clean room system design are: first one, supplying airflow with sufficient volume and cleanliness. Of course, now the air conditioning unit is taking in the used air from the room or the space, cleaning it, cooling it, dehumidifying it, and giving it back to the room as a supply air. So return air taking in, supply air given out. Now the supply air that is coming into the space should come with a substantial volume and cleanliness. Cleanliness is, it has to be filtered appropriately from all the impurities that are laden in it. Then it should have sufficient volume. If you give a small jet of air, it is not even going to impact the ventilation in the space or exhausting that which is already created. So a very substantial volume of air has to be given into the space to clear the space or purge the space out of the existing air volume. So air changes per hour is quite evidently on the higher side in a clean room. So introducing air in a manner to prevent stagnant areas where particles are accumulated, could accumulate. So if we, while designing, we have to keep in bear in mind that the air supply that is happening into the room should happen in such a precise, smooth manner that it prevents stagnant pockets in the room where air is getting bottled up or stuck. So that air is going to be laden with impurities and it is going to be dispersed into the room again as a backdraft. So avoiding this kind of stagnation of air in the room is very essential. Because those impurities are again going to settle onto the various surfaces, furniture, people, and if it were a ward which is doing research on a virus, the person is going to carry it out, and if not careful, it is going to be a task in itself. Third consideration, conditioning the air to meet clean room temperature, humidity, and filtration requirement. So clean room is designed to come with the indoor air with a certain level of, with a certain temperature, expected humidity and filtration requirements which could be beyond 99%. So that is the requirement we would have calculated based on the heat load incurred or the contamination that may be expected in the room. So based on that, the professional would have deduced this is the temperature that is advisable here, this is the humidity, and we need to filter out the air to such an extent. So we will design a system, an equipment, a duct design and a filtration system which will enable this maintenance of this kind of ambient comfort condition in the specified clean room. Ensuring enough makeup air to maintain the specified positive pressurization. So it only means that when you have a high pressure in a given space, higher than the corresponding adjacent space, there is the infiltration of air from the outside to inside is going to be limited or curtailed. Hence, we have to maintain the clean rooms at a specified positive pressurization at all times. And maintaining this has to be designed as a part of the HVAC system or the mechanical ventilation system. Appropriate maintenance of positive pressure when compared to the adjacent lobbies or spaces, etc. So ensuring, fourth point, you maintain a conditioned makeup air. That is, you will be purging or you will be forcing air into the space to maintain the specified positive high pressure. So besides the room preparation, in terms of materials and finishes, played equally important role in meeting these requirements. So So the role of selection of the right materials and finishes for the various surfaces is critical in designing a clean room. The idea and what is the objective behind this? To minimize the internal generation of contaminants from the surfaces itself. See, for one point, we are making all efforts to keep the indoor air at a certain temperature, cool, chilled temperature, at a high pressure, and zero level contamination. So after doing all this, what we realize is the materials that are used in the room themselves are giving out some kind of a residue or contaminant, then the whole point of HVAC is lost. The architect has definitely not thought about the second angle to the clean room. So as an architect, it is the scope of work in our realm to select the right materials and finishes for the clean room interiors. Most critical, apart from the first part of preparing the indoor air. So we will keep that in mind. This the images are from Otafab, which is a provider for clean room finishing products. We are going to elaborate some of these points ahead. Now, the question might arise, how does a clean room differ from an ordinarily ventilated or conditioned room? There is a room which is air conditioned anyways, but how is this clean room different from the ordinary rooms or ordinary ACs? So, some points of the consideration always that we saw in the previous few slides should lead us to understanding this. Those were the points on which we are basing the aspects. So, three ways now. Increased air supply. Now, this is in correlation to the consideration or the aspect that we had to maintain there, that was high pressure in the room and high volume of air with a good velocity. So here we are increasing the air supply. These are the actual manner in which you can enable the previously discussed points. Normal air conditioning systems are designed for 0.5 to 2 air changes per hour, ACH, essentially based on the occupancy level. So a clean room would have at least 10 air changes per hour, minimum 10 for the simplest of clean rooms, and could be as high as 600 for absolute cleanliness. So that is the first way in which first parameter of difference between a normal air conditioned room and a clean room. The air changes per hour in the room is substantially high. Just to recollect, what is ACH? Now, if we say 2 ACH, it refers to the aspect that in an hour, the existing volume of the air in the room completely has to be removed and replaced with fresh clean air 2 times. So, if it were a clean room, minimum 10 times you have to evacuate the room of the existing vitiated air and replace it with the clean, cool, tempered air. 600, imagine, per hour. And there are clean rooms which are rated as class 100, class 1000. So as we go higher, the efficiency of the clean rooms is maximum. Operation theatres, most cleanest rooms possible. Second point, how do they differ? The use of high efficiency filters. To filter the supply air into a clean room to ensure the removal of small particles. They are installed at the point of air discharge into the room. So normally, if you had noticed, the filters were at what end of the AC unit or AHU? They were at the return air grill before the air went on to the evaporator or the cooling coil. So here, in addition to that, you will have So in addition to the filters at the return air, you will have it at the supply end also. That is the point of air discharge. Third point, room pressurization. The clean room is positive pressurized with respect to the adjacent areas. So a high pressure is always maintained in a clean room space. How do we do it? This is done by supplying more air quantity and extracting less air quantity from the room than is supplied to it. So the more the air volume, the higher the pressure. So this was one point of consideration we had seen earlier. Maintain the clean room at a positive. Now if you see in this, zero pressure is the outside area, adjacent area. Then there is a positive, single positive here, that is the buffer area. Then double positive is the actual clean room area. So this could be the operation theater or the whatever that is, and this could be the ante room. Before you actually enter that. And it could be the also place where the people entering the clean room have to change into the clean room clothing. Okay. Now, the contamination in a clean room is controlled by 5 steps. 1. Design and construction of the clean room. 2. What are the equipment used? 3. The procedures adopted. 5th one, activity of the personnel in the clean room, the people who are using the clean room. 5th one, maintenance of the clean room. We should cover maintenance, housekeeping, etc. So cleaning the clean room post usage. So these are 5 steps by which we can ensure that the contamination in the clean room is matching with our expectations or objectives. If it is quite a complex process and a continued process, and before usage also we have to be very critical on the design and construction. So the first and the second are very critical to us as architects, designing appropriately, constructing well in line with the clean room norms, equipment that are used in the clean room. Further, the procedures adopted, the people using, the maintenance, post-occupancy or post-cycle also is critical. Now, important aspects of design, elaborating these. By proper air filtration and pressurization of the room, entry of particles, dust, fibers, bacteria can be prevented. Of course, when you maintain a room at a high pressure, we can ensure that the dust and dirt and other dispersed elements in the air will not enter the clean room. And also by proper filtration levels that should be incorporated in the AC filters, in the air distribution system. Particles are generated continuously in the room by the movement of personnel and by the machines that are operated. Particles are generated, there is perspiration, there is breathing out. the machines are undertaking some kind of a function, they will give out some kind of output, some of them minor amounts of carbon monoxide, or because these are all cutting edge equipment or instruments that are used. So they will have some kind of a output. So there is essentially we have to keep track of getting into the right attire meant for the entry into clean rooms. To eliminate this, a continuous process of purging of room air is adopted. Purging is pumping out or removing, exhausting the air out of a given space. So that has to be continuously undertaken. Continuously flushing, purging the air from the room. So that will keep the contamination to the limited levels. For normal rooms, purging is 3 to 5 air changes per hour. So 5 times per hour the air volume has to be changed. For sterile clean rooms, it is 15 to 20 air changes per hour. 20 times the entire volume of air in the room has to be exhausted. Not just exhausted, totally evacuated and replaced with a clean, safer, cool air. 40 to 60 air changes per hour for class 1000 rooms, which have very high levels of cleanliness expected. 600 air changes are also used in certain critically required clean rooms. Appropriate selection of material for construction, paints, clothing of personnel, everything has to be in methodologically in place. So you will find a good amount of market products, different manufacturers with perfect specification written there and the costing, etc. If these are FRP wall panels, which are very smooth and unlikely to give out any residue or dirt or dust into the space. So the surfaces are mostly very clean, smooth basically. Coarse ones are the ones which give out some kind of a residue. But because of wear and tear or chip off, which is not overnight, but over the time, very minute microns is also enough to contaminate the air in a clean room. So this is a glass board. It's a registered item by storauniversal.com. FRP wall panels, and additionally we also have to think about the fire rating. Now I'm talking about one angle, that is the mechanical or HVAC. But when you are doing the fire module, I'm sure you would have come across how critical firefighting is for a building. So all these should suffice in such a building design. Never negate one. If I am teaching HVAC, it doesn't mean only HVAC to be considered. No, you have to imply the learnings from all services, and a wholesome services plan has to be created. So FRP panel fire rating C, class A, that is solid combustibles, right? Class C, liquid and gas combustibles, A, wood and all those kind of actual paper. Sizes are mentioned, so you will have a platter of sizes to choose from, specifications to choose from. This is another example. We will just read it just to be aware of what kind of products are available and specifications there. Nicomac Pharmaceutical Modular Clean Room Walls. Modular because they do not require on-site labor or works to be done. They are ready, factory assembled, and factory manufactured and ready to be assembled. They are a composite construction of two skins of high-pressure plastic laminate over an aluminum framework with a sealed and insulated interior. Standard room panel dimensions are given there, and they have an overall thickness of so much. That's how it is, the first one. Second one, stainless steel fleet room partition panels, vintage Impex, pharmaceutical clean room manufacturer. So they have their own signature products and styles to cater to specific typological buildings and clean rooms associated with them. So personnel should change their dress to lint-free clothing before entering the room. It's a prerogative. Whatever clothes, for instance, whatever I'm wearing, may give out lint at some point of time. The small fibery element that comes out, that has to be totally entering the room. Pass through air shower in the anteroom or an air lock to the clean room. So these two aspects are with respect to the user entering the space. Hence, there are lots of articles. So clean room apparel consists of various pieces that, when donned correctly, form a suit that covers almost complete body parts, and it will generally comprise of coverall, face mask, goggles, boots. And I think the past 1.5 years with the COVID-19, we have seen many of these images flashing by on the media or experienced ourselves. So that is the criticality of how a personnel has to be rightly dressed before entering a clean room. And pass through air shower in the anteroom, that is the room, buffer room, before you enter the actual clean room. That's called an air lock. So you are undergoing air shower, and the probable dispersed dirt or dust on your body is cleared in the space, and that room also is purged often, right? So we will continue with this in the next lecture. Till here, so we have seen introduction to clean rooms, and we have started to look at the important aspects of design. So see you on the next slide on the next lecture platform.